Lift and tow is the fastest and most efficient way to get any tow job done. How fast? In as little as 35 seconds, you can lift a car and be on your way. The lift and tow system lifts up to 3,500 pounds, tows up to 7,500 pounds, and can be easily installed on 3/4-ton trucks or larger. Whether we ship the unit directly to you or our trained technicians install it here at our shop, all units come with everything you need, including the straps. Lift and tow is available in three different models: the 3 Series, a power up and down manual in and out unit, the 5 Series, a power up and down in and out unit, and the Z Series with its patented Z-bar construction. All you have to do is back up your truck and push the buttons. It's the quickest repo unit on the market today, and over 2,000 units have been sold in the past decade alone. At Lift and Tow, we are the manufacturers, so you can be assured of a quality product at a fair price each and every time. And if you should have any questions or problems, we have a complete service and support staff ready and eager to assist you. Lift and Tow, for over 15 years, our name has said it all.
Welcome to American Towman TV. American Towman TV.
Hi, I'm Emily Oz with American Towman TV. On this edition of Tow Industry Week, the new year is off to a rough start for towers on the police rotation in Detroit, Michigan. In December, city leaders took a rogue stance and decided to seize control of all their police impound business. The move takes the business of storing 30,000 vehicles annually away from the 26 companies currently on the rotation.
The members have seen a pretty steep decline, pretty swift and steep decline in calls for service.
That's Peggy Goodwin with the Detroit Authorized Towing Association, or DATA, which is actively fighting the city's decision because they say it violates city codes. DATA has the full support of the Detroit Police Commission too, both seen meeting here with city leaders in December.
So it really has been a really unreasonable fight for the police authorized towers in Detroit, because there's really no real concrete data and real concrete case made to say, oh, if the city runs this and we, you know, get rid of all these towers, all these small businesses that have served our community for all these years, we're going to, you know, this is going to resolve our deficit. It's not. It's going to put the city into a state of, you know, more shuttered businesses.
Keep in mind, the 18 DATA member tow companies recently invested a whopping combined $36 million to bring their tow yards up to code at the city's request. Police towers have 3 million square feet of real estate in the city to conduct business, while the city owns one yard.
We're talking about one small impound yard that is owned by the city. We don't know if it's up to code like these police authorized towers are up to code, spent the money, invested. How do you store 30,000 vehicles in one impound yard? I mean, the city hasn't run anything effectively. How are they going to run a towing process effectively? I mean, we can't even resolve the crimes we have. We, you know, the lights aren't turned on properly in most parts of the city. So again, how is this a priority for the city to take over this and think that they're going to profit from it?
DATA is meeting again with the city council this week. We'll keep you posted on what happens next in the fight for towers in Detroit. Thanks for watching American Towman TV.